front and total final blessing. Also, we ask that you refrain from confetti in the church and on the steps of the church because of the mess it makes people coming in. And lastly, just a reminder that at 5:30 there's a buffet and you're all invited, and the buffet is at Steve's place. So, that's my announcement. Why you may not be married, I charge it to swore God the searcher of all hearts that you now declare to me. Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, in whom we live and move and have our being, grant unto us purity of heart and strength of purpose, so that no selfish passion may hinder us from knowing your will, and no weakness from doing it. And in your life we may see life, and in your service find perfect freedom. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Let us hear from the Word of God, Ephesians chapter 3, verses 14 to 19. For this reason I bow my knees before the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named, that according to the riches of his glory, he may grant you to be strengthened with might through his Spirit in the inner man, and that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith, that you, being rooted and grounded in love, may have power to comprehend with all the saints what is the breadth and length and height and depth, and to know the love of Christ which surpasses knowledge, that you may be filled with all the fullness of God. Here ends our reading of God's holy word. Amen. Friends and acquaintances with the family, we are gathered here in God's presence to witness the marriage of Steve and Pam, and to ask God's blessing. By our presence here, we accept responsibility for supporting them in the marriage that they are to enter. It's a new relationship, and so we are called to rejoice with them in happiness, to be patient when they make mistakes, and to help them in times of trouble, and to remember them in our prayers. God established marriage that man and woman might have lifelong companionship, that natural instincts and affections might be fulfilled in mutual love, that children might have the benefit of family life, and that society might rest on a firm foundation. The Apostle Paul compared marriage to that of Christ for his church. Thus he gave us a new vision of what marriage ought to be, a life of self-giving love. Steve and Pam, your marriage joins you for life in a relationship so intimate that it profoundly affects your whole being. It offers you the promise of a love that is true and mature. Such a love requires that you commit yourselves and your lives to each other freely, openly, and honestly. There should be no reserve in your love. Seek to become one in mind and heart, as well as one in body, and trust in the love and the care of our Lord Jesus Christ to guide and support you. And so as you come to make your vows and to be joined together in marriage, let us pray. Almighty God, from the beginning, has made man and woman for each other. Let thy Holy Spirit rest upon these thy servants, as in thy name they pledge themselves to one another in vows of love and faithfulness. Let thy love be upon them as their hope is in thee. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Steve, will you have Pam to be your wife? And we have Steve to be your husband. Who gives this woman to be married to this man? In the presence of God, before these witnesses, I see that you can be my wife. Happens to hold For as much as Stephen Spence and Pamela Robertson have made the solemn covenant of marriage before God and this company, I declare them to be husband and wife in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Gracious Father, whose love is everlasting, grant that Stephen and Pam may dwell together in unity and love all the days of their life. Give them health, prosperity, and peace. Strengthen them to obey and serve, that they may walk in the steps of Jesus Christ, thy Son. And when the joys and sorrows and all the good and evil of this passing world are ended, let them inherit thy promises and share in thine eternal glory. O God, our Heavenly Father, look in favor upon all our wants. Defend them against evil from within and without, and supply their needs according to the riches of thy grace. For ourselves also we pray, O Lord, that directed by thy Spirit we may look each to the good of the others in word and deed, and grow in grace as we advance in years. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who taught us to pray, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power, and glory, forever and ever. Amen. Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you now and forevermore.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am pleased to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Steve Spence. I gave another one, Spencey. I didn't get all that one.
No, just pretend.
Just pretend.
Words, Spencey?
What?
Any last words?
Mm-hmm.
Any last words?